on here a lot.
Yeah, how's it going?
Good, good. How you doing, buddy?
Always good.
Beauty, where are you headed to this beautiful day?
Delivering this in Preston, and then I'm coming back over this way, picking up a load from KLC. Is brought to you by Sutco Transportation. Sutco's hiring Class 1 drivers in British Columbia and Alberta. To apply, go to sutco.ca and use promo code JuanFan to get an extra $100 on your first payday. Good morning. Actually, kind of grumpy morning. I just felt like I didn't get enough sleep. I don't know why. I got enough hours. Got up here in the morning. It's raining. And my pre-trip, one marker light is out. For some reason, I didn't catch that last night when I did my post-trip, but post-trip was pretty quick. We are on Highway 3. Well, I guess I am. I are. Up to Salmo, we're headed towards Creston. Won't drive all the way into Creston because delivering on this end of Creston. Summer. Figure it's raining. It's 8 degrees Celsius outside. Nice cool day. Which is the tallest pass highway goes over in British Columbia. Not to say that's a super tall pass. Lasting Monday, now until July 1st. Expect delays between 7 a.m. and okay. Guess I need to expect delays. Yeah, some of the passes in the U.S. are much, much higher than any passes in British Columbia. The U.S. has much higher mountains. I do find that the U.S. grades are not as steep, though. Most of the time. Again, trying to find it. Tried looking before, couldn't find it. No vibration when Jess is sitting in it, no vibration when the seat's lowered all the way down. But when no one's sitting in it and it's aired out, it vibrates. That annoying, clicking sound. River, which flows into the Monterey River, which flows into the Columbia River. I stopped. Somehow I got out of that pattern. Just noticed it last week. He goes, "You not take any vitamins anymore?" I'm like, "Huh. I guess not." Tailings pond here to our right hand side. Must have been a mine back here back in the day. So it's not a huge tailings pond, but there is a tailings pond. Or at least there used to be a tailings. that sign we just passed said, we're leaving Salmo Fire Protection Area. Which means anyone living out here, anyone driving down this road, doesn't actually have emergency service coverage. Not in a reasonable time, anyway. Because the next town is Preston, and that's way on the other side of this pass. Speed grades here coming. That sign said 8% grades up. Not very often do you get warnings that you go uphill if there's a speed grade. This is one of those you get a warning to go uphill. 8% grade. It's only a short section, it's 8%, but if you're going to spin out in the winter, that's where you're going to spin out. Tow truck to tow me up the one time. I spun out and put all chains on, all four drives. I guess all four. Both axles are all four duals, which is eight tires, and chains on them, and I could not get moving. It stops raining for me. We got a bunch of drywall and gypsum on the back, and I can't get wet. that little creek is like a raging river right now. I'm not sure what this river or creek is called, but pretty cool. Take that cough. I find most of them I do better after I take an allergy pill, so I should do that. behind us. Mirror heat on, so keeping the mirror fairly clear. It's not raining hard enough to make the mirror useless. If the mirror heat was off, then it would be useless. But I find the mirror heat extremely useful all summer long.
Get a little scratchy here, so safe travels. I'll see you along the road.
Party lock, taxi.
That's interesting. It's not necessarily stolen, but missing. That is interesting. So that truck driver does not work for Sutco, but he used to work for Sutco, and his spouse is a dispatcher. That's why he said, talk to your dispatcher. Awesome, peoples. It'd be weird that it's actually stolen. Maybe somebody brought it to a shop without telling the driver. Yeah, I'll have to dig for more info for sure. Because the yard gets locked up. Doesn't make sense. Unless it's someone that knows, or they are getting shared by a couple of companies. So it's not just Sutco Trucks parked in there. There's a couple of companies that parked in there. And it's access to a gravel pit. So maybe one of those left the gate open, or it could be a former disgruntled employee that used to work for one of those companies. Or it's simple as someone took the truck to the maintenance shop and didn't tell the driver. I mean, we got a maintenance shop right there in the yard, but maybe it's something that they could. Well, that doesn't make sense. They can fix anything trailer. If anything, there might be a truck that they could fix. They would pull the truck down to a dealership. But the shop in the yard can do anything related to trailers. So no, that doesn't make any sense. I'll see if I can get some more info for you guys in the next couple of days. 38 kilometers per hour up this hill. You're supposed to pass me, not tucking behind me. You don't want to be behind me for this. I flipped over the stop sign, but then saw me coming. Back to slow. Blasting this avalanche area here. Looks to me trying to make a bit of a gap. Avalanche as I come down, an avalanche sitting inside that gap instead of taking the highway out. sense?
No.
Is that snow? June 13th. That's snowing. Let it snow, let it snow, let it snow. Are those four letter words I need to add it out? Thank you. we go. The steepest section is done. Went down in 13th gear. Held me back pretty good. Barely, but did a pretty good job. Going downhill pretty steep, but I can do it at 18th gear. I guess it's not really that steep, but still going downhill then. I'll need to downshift a couple of times. Slow down, caution, uneven pavement. Okay, let's slow down then. Highway's been sliding off the side of the cliff. Yeah, the whole highway's been sliding off the side of the cliff. Wow. Dropped quite a few inches. That black and red paint job looked kind of cool. Yeah, I guess the ground is still thawing out over here, up on the top of the pass. The whole highway's kind of dropped a couple inches. A little concerning. Will it give up when a heavy big rig hits it? Watch the whole highway slide down. Just those engineers that have come out and assessed that it's still safe for big rigs to go over. this area, areas like that would just disappear down the mountain. So much ground moisture in it. A little liquefaction would happen and the whole mountain, the whole road would just slide right down. Remind me not to be here during an earthquake. Logging truck. Guys, I guess we're approaching our hour here. Still another 20 minutes to Creston, so my GPS says it would take an hour to get to Creston when we started, but you know, when you're driving half the speed limit, it takes longer. I guess 20 minutes longer. Guys, go. Hopefully you guys enjoyed Kootenai Pass and CBSE. CBSE is our British Columbia's version of DOT. Commercial Vehicle Inspection and Enforcement. CBSE, Commercial Vehicle Safety and Enforcement. I think that's it. CBSE. Yes, officer, I have a defect. I have two defects. A cracked windshield and a marker light. Yes, officer, we have plans to fix it. Windshield will be fixed in October. And the marker light will probably get fixed today if we can time it out and stop by a shop. Anyway, yeah, right, I was letting you guys go. Thank you guys for watching, thank you for supporting me. Really, really appreciate it. I am out of here. You guys rock.